You're listening to the Steward Media and Entertainment Network, home of the number one sports talk show on the planet, The Doug Stewart Show.
This is a revolution in radio, the realest, trillest sports talk show in America, The Doug Stewart Show.
Broadcasting live Monday through Friday, 10 a.m. to noon Eastern Time, exclusively on the Steward Media and Entertainment Network.
This is sports talk for the people.
Follow Steward Media and Entertainment right now on Facebook to stay connected and locked in for upcoming events like the Couples and Cocktail Series, viewing parties, and much, much more. Up next, get ready to ride raw with the Doug Stewart Show.
This is Sports Talk with Hot Sauce, Texas Pete Hot Sauce, the Doug Stewart Show.
Exclusively on the Steward Media and Entertainment Network.
Yes!
San Jose sports fans are winning huge cash prizes every day at DraftKings.com, America's favorite place to play daily fantasy sports. Daily fantasy means no season-long commitments. Play whenever you want. Just pick your sport and draft your team. It's like a new season every time you play, so you're never stuck with the same players. Last year, $300 million were won at DraftKings.com, and you could be next to win big. Go to DraftKings.com now and enter promo code STEW to play for free. That's STEW for free entry now at DraftKings.com. Also, if you use promo code STEW, DraftKings will match your initial deposit up to $600. Deposit $600, play with $1,200. DraftKings.com, promo code STEW.
At Ticket Liquidator, we believe you should have access to the experiences you want to be a part of. Since 2003, Ticket Liquidator has been connecting buyers and sellers with the most sought-after and often sold-out events across the country. Ticket Liquidator's nationwide network gives you access to one of the largest online inventories of sports, theater, and concert tickets, with prices lower than most companies in other markets. And our security policies are solid, so you can buy with absolute confidence. More tickets, better service, and lower prices, so you can witness the best entertainment, culture, and sports events worldwide. At Ticket Liquidator, we know that seeing a legend bring down the house or watching your team win the championship is about more than a ticket. It's about being there. For all your sports and entertainment ticket needs, call us at 855-638-3034. Again, that's 855-638-3034.
Doctor, this is the mayor talking.
All right.
Doctor.
Come on, what?
Always do the right thing.
If you came here to hear for fake, you are in the wrong place. We are for real around here. We keep it real. This is the Doug Stewart Show, the livest, the realest, the trillest sports talk show in America. Are you not entertained?
This is Sports Talk with Hot Sauce.
Texas Pete Hot Sauce, the Doug Stewart Show.
Yeah!
Game time. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. What's happening? Welcome to the Doug Stewart Show. This is a Throwback Thursday. And oh boy, we got a lot of great stuff to get into today. Thank you for joining your folk. I really do appreciate it. Yeah. Ooh, one of my favorite days of the week. Throwback Thursday, just because it's almost the end of the week. You know how we get down. It's all good. Yeah, you know how we do it. Bring it back one more time. Shout out to all of the Stewies. We almost home, baby. Hey, the number to the show is 404-382-0338. You can also email me at Doug at thedougstewartshow.com. Shouts out to all of the Stewies already in the chat room doing their chat thing. If you're a new listener to the Doug Stewart Show, man, welcome to the show. Thank you very much for joining me. Once again, a Throwback Thursday, August 27th, 2015, a day after my anniversary. And I lied to y'all yesterday, man. Of course I had something for my wife for our 20-year anniversary. I got her some flowers delivered to our job. Ladies still like that, right? tree, give me a thumbs up on that. I mean, that had to work. that had to work. Yesterday, if you're new to the show, if this is the first time you're listening, or if you didn't hear the show on yesterday, I talked about it being my 20-year anniversary to my wife, Monica, and I didn't buy her anything. And she bought me this nice watch and a card and all of that stuff, and I surprised her. And so I know she was listening. I knew she was listening, so I said I didn't get her anything, and that sounded like a schlep. And actually, I did. I have some nice flowers delivered to her. You know, hey, I'm daddy. I'm daddy. Hey, if you're new to the show, man, follow the show on Spreaker.com, the Doug Stewart Show on Spreaker.com, on the Stewart Media and Entertainment Network. So when you're in Spreaker, if you search the Doug Stewart Show or if you search Stewart Media and Entertainment, you'll find it. Hit the little follow button, and that's very important. So when you follow the show, whenever we go live, whenever we air a new show, like what we did yesterday with the Kicking It with Kesey show, well, I'll talk about that more in a second, you'll be alerted. And it's a big thing. And as a matter of fact, speaking of which, and you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show, let me look at something right here. Let me look. Yes! We just crossed 9,000 followers yesterday. Yes! 9,000 followers, 9,018 followers to the Doug Stewart Show. What, yesterday?
The goal is 10,000 before 9:22.
10,000. We are trying to get 10,000 followers to the Doug Stewart Show on Spreaker.com before our birthday on September 22nd, okay, which is right around the corner. We're right at a month out from September 22nd. So if you haven't hit the little follow button yet and you've been listening, or if you're new, hit the little follow button, man. And we're trying to get 10,000 followers in the next 4 weeks, or get to 10,000 in the next 4 weeks, man. That's a huge accomplishment. Thank y'all very much. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Praise God. Praise His holy name. Special shout out to the first ever new show aired on the Stewart Media and Entertainment Network yesterday. The Kicking It with Kesey show premiered yesterday at 2 p.m. Everything went off without a hitch. The engineering aspect of that whole thing, we've been making sure we nailed down and got it exactly right, and we did. It came across. No hitches at all, once again. Shouts out to Kesey, man, the Kicking It with Kesey show. When you get a second, if you didn't hear it yesterday, go back and listen to it, man. He interviewed, what was her name? Jillian Harper? I'm sorry. What was
her name?
Tammy Harper. Where the hell did I get Jillian from? I know a Jillian Harper. That's why it is. But he interviewed a working professional musician, keyboardist here in Atlanta, Tammy Harper, on yesterday. It was only 30 minutes, but it was great stuff, man. And Stewart Media and Entertainment is on a roll. Yes, sir. Shouts out to you, Kesey. So if you'd like to broadcast your show on the Stewart Media and Entertainment Network, and we're going to get to all of the sports stuff here in a second, trust me, but I got to do this. If you'd like to broadcast or have your show broadcast on the Stewart Media and Entertainment Network, to have the availability to tie into over 9,000 followers to the network and to the Doug Stewart Show, home of the Doug Stewart Show, then hit me up on Fiverr, okay? That's Fiverr, Fiverr.com. And starting as low as $5, going up based on what you're trying to do, we can actually even engineer your show, where we do all of the behind-the-scenes engineering as far as music introductions, running the show. All you do is talk. So we can do that, or we can go all the way down to just you giving us an MP3 of a finished product, and we airing it live on the network, and you know, giving you, once again, that availability to over 9,000 followers on the Stewart Media and Entertainment Network. So Fiverr.com, and get all the details. There's a video about it and everything, so it's real good. Also, I just talked about it. 1 year anniversary of the Doug Stewart Show coming up next month, September 22nd. We are celebrating big Willie style. That's a low country term. With a huge weekend of events going on. I'm calling it TDSS weekend. the Doug Stewart Show weekend, where Friday night there's a meet and greet party in downtown ATL. Friday night as well, late Friday night, we're going on a gentleman's soiree. Yeah, to one of the local shoe modeling establishments. Then Saturday morning, there's a golf tournament. Saturday night, the coup de grace, the all-black party downtown, ATL and Buckhead at the Doubletree Hotel. And then Sunday, before you get back on the road, if you're coming from out of town, Sunday, Falcons-Cowboys viewing party downtown ATL on the rooftop at Sweet Lounge. One price and you eat for free. You eat for free. You party for free. DJ Bing doing it. The Two Live Stews tailgate. DJ. So it's going to be crazy, man. Fantastic weekend. Get all the details at tdssweekend.eventbrite.com. All right? tdssweekend.eventbrite.com. All right. On today's show, man, you see the title of the show, man. Throwback Thursday, see the title says Hate for Vic, Realer Than the Real Deal Holyfield, and it is, and I'm sure you've seen all the stories. We'll talk about that today. Derrick Rose, some accusations made against the point guard for the Chicago Bulls. We'll get into that. Kobe and Shaq kissed and made up. Yes! We'll discuss that. And another major injury in the NFL. Yeah, we'll get into all of those things. UCLA has a quarterback. It's kind of a surprising decision about that. We'll do that as well. And today, we'll continue with our preseason football reports. So today we're going to talk about the Houston Texans, who are on that Hard Knocks TV show on HBO. I'm not caught up with Hard Knocks yet. I think they've already done the third episode. I haven't seen the third episode yet. But and you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show. But I saw the second episode, man. Good stuff. You saw that interaction. If you watch Hard Knocks, there was this interaction between these two defensive players. And one of them is kind of like a guy that's been here on the team for like 3 years. He was talking to an undrafted rookie, and the first guy was an undrafted rookie as well. And they had some type of miscommunication on defense, and dude was on the sideline telling the this year's rookie, like, look, bruh. This is real. Like, we got to get this stuff together. And the guy was like, man, calm down, calm down. And the older guy, the veteran guy, was like, no, no, it's no calm down about this. Do you understand? They will cut our ass. Do you understand that we have a very minimal amount of time to get this right and show these guys we can play, or we are going home? And it's real. And I love that Hard Knock show, man, because they show how real it is and how when a guy gets cut, like, it's a wrap. Like, bring me your playbook. Come to the office. It is a wrap. And so you really, really have to show what you can do, and you got to be smart. There's a lot of cats out there that are great athletes, but they ain't smart. You know, they dumb on the field. And it's all about how fast can you pick things up, and especially in this day and time in the NFL where they limit training camps and you don't have a long opportunity to get it right. I love that, man. I love Hard Knocks. My boy Jadeveon Clowney, my homeboy, back. He's going to be ready to go, supposedly, at the start of the season for the Texans. So today we'll break down the Houston Texans and get all your conversation about Jadeveon Clowney and Brian Hoyer and all of those cats today on the Doug Stewart Show. All right, the number to the show is 404-382-0338. You can also email me at Doug@thedougstewartshow.com. The easy way to be totally interactive, though, is by hitting me up in the chat on Spreaker.com. Not only should you be following the show on Spreaker.com, you should download my app, the Doug Stewart Show app, the Stewart Media and Entertainment app, as well as checking me out on the DougStewartShow.com as well. All right, when we get back from the break, little conversation about this Mike Vick hate, man. And I'm a dude that doesn't really even like to use the term hate because I think it's overused today. But there's no better word to explain what Mike Vick is facing right now, man. So we'll talk about that up next on the Doug Stewart Show. Don't go away. In life, things happen, good and bad. And being prepared is always important. If you're like me, a husband, a father, and protector of that family tree, then your family is the most important thing in the world. 95 million U.S. adults don't have protection in place. So, What I've done is put my protection in the hands of the largest and number one independent financial services company in North America, and that's Primerica. They look out for middle America because they believe that offering the most competitive premiums only benefits the client and have been doing so since 1977. If you're a parent, husband, or wife and want to discuss options with one of Primerica's top reps, then call my guy, Greg Wynn, at 678-439-7172. Again, that's 678-439-7172, and he'll put your family first. And hey, tell him that Doug Stewart sent you. Yes!
The Doug Stewart Show presents another episode of Stories with Uncle Dougie, straight out of Month's Corner edition.
So my best friend, man, Bubba, he gets on the bus, and he sits down, and he's like distraught. And I'm like, dude, what's going on? We're on the bus on the way to school. We're like in 9th, 10th grade, and we're on the bus on the way to school. And he says, my old man, you know, he shot a man last night. I was like, wait a minute. What did you say? And I had heard these stories before. And rest in peace, his daddy's name was Coconut. Coconut was a little guy, probably 5'5", about, I don't know, 140 pounds. So he's a little dude. And little dudes, man, they don't got the tolerance to wrestle with you or fight or put up their hands or something like that, especially old cats like this where I'm from. He's like, my old man stumbled in 4 o'clock in the morning, and I met him in the hallway because he was extra intoxicated. And he looked at me and said, Bubba, I had to shoot a man tonight. And come to find out more of the story. Now, keep in mind, this was in 1985 or something like this. Coconut was probably in his late 50s. Early 60s, and once again, I told you, the story on the street was that he had done this many times before. Come to find out, Coconut had shot 4, maybe 5 people throughout his life in our little town in Monk's Corner, South Carolina. This is not a lie, and I know this seems like a story from the Andy Griffith Show, from Ernest T. Bass. This is not a lie. In my hometown, you can literally shoot people or shoot at people, connect on their lower extremities 4, 5, 6 times and not go to jail forever.
The Doug Stewart Show.
Fantasy sports fans are winning huge cash prizes every day at DraftKings.com, America's favorite place to play daily fantasy sports. Daily fantasy means no season-long commitments. Play whenever you want. Just pick your sport and draft your team. It's like a new season every time you play. So, you're never stuck with the same players. Last year, $300 million were won at DraftKings.com, and you could be next to win big. Go to DraftKings.com now and enter promo code STU to play for free. That's STU for free entry now at DraftKings.com. Also, if you use promo code STU, DraftKings will match your initial deposit up to $600. Deposit $600, play with $1,200. DraftKings.com, promo code STU.
They say this is a big rich town. I just come from the poorest part. Bright lights.
Man, if y'all could,
I gotta make it, this is where it goes.
If y'all could only hear a boy trying to get right during the breaks.
I just come apart.
Tree is just flabbergasted.
I never took a straight path.
I wish we could record though.
Life full of twists and turns.
I'm sorry, say that again, Tree.
I wish we could record though, so people can really understand what I have to deal in and day out.
Yeah, your boy got a little issues with his sinuses and whatnot. But it's all good. It's all good. The voice you hear in the background behind 50 Cent in a big rich town is the Tree of Life, the producer to the Doug Stewart Show. One of the greatest producers in the history of producers. Shouts out to my man, J.B. Jennings. Happy birthday, J.B. Jennings, one of the Stewies. I understand today is your birthday, man. Happy birthday, bruh. If you come to the all-black party on the weekend of September 26th, and remind me, I'll buy your first drink if I got any more drink tickets left. So yeah, the weekend of September 26th, we'll go down to the ATL and celebrate. We'll celebrate your birthday, and we'll celebrate TDSS's birthday as well. Speaking of, Speaking of big stuff going on and birthdays and celebrations, stay tuned. Stay tuned, man. Stay tuned to the Doug Stewart Show, because I have, and I've had a lot of big announcements on this show in the last year. I mean, oh, we always have big announcements. I had a big announcement when we had on Richard Sherman. I built it up and said we had a big announcement. Who else did we have it on? We had on a couple of great guests on the show over the last year. And I always build it up. I was like, man, I got a big announcement. Are we about to do this? Or we got a big announcement this, a big announcement that. No, I'm serious this time. I'm really serious this time. We got a huge, I mean, a big ass. When you're talking about big asses, I'm talking about Shirley from What's Happening Big Ass announcement. Okay? I got a big ass announcement coming up. Stay tuned. Yes, sir. Just stay tuned to the Doug Stewart Show, man. And I think we might give it to you. I'm gonna tell you right now, we're not giving it to you today. I mean, we're not giving you the big announcement today. But just know, and this ain't no, and you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show. This ain't no. We might have a big announcement. No, it's a done deal. Right? It's a done deal. It's a R-A-P. It's a wrap. I got a big ass announcement for y'all. Stay tuned. I'm talking about, when you talk about the annals of big asses, I mean, it's kind of like a Kim Kardashian big ass announcement.
The annals of big and truffle. Okay, never mind.
Speaking of which, you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show. Tree, jump back on the mic for a second. Yesterday, I asked you, and as PG as we can do this, yesterday I asked you to go on UrbanDictionary.com and research the term that these young people are using, and there's a song about it, as a matter of fact, called Truffle Butter. And I asked you to go on there and see if you could find the definition of truffle butter and what it meant. And so I'm asking you to report back. What do you? Did you find out what it means, truffle butter?
Is this some kind of harassment that you're doing right now?
What do you mean harassment?
I don't believe I need to report back. All I can say is mortified.
Yeah.
Mortified.
Yeah. Truffle butter ain't what you mean. It's not a light spread that you spread over your bread.
It's not pasta sauce.
It's not pasta sauce. It's disgusting. I mean, it's disgusting. So, see, this is what we do. Public service announcement around here on the Doug Stewart Show. If your child at home talking about truffle butter this and truffle butter that, it ain't what you're thinking. I mean, it's not what you're thinking. It's actually disgusting. Oh, my gosh. 404-382-0338 is the number to the show. This is the Doug Stewart Show. You can also email me or hit me up on Spreaker.com and get your thoughts. And we read a lot of your chat on the show. We'll get into some of that here in the next couple of segments. We do birthdays. We have a good time, man. Top fives. I mean, this is the most fun show on turf, the Doug Stewart Show. So we talked about it yesterday, man, on Mike Vick signs with the Pittsburgh Steelers and the outrage that came from Steelers fans nationwide. On National Dog Day, a handful of protesters convened outside the Pittsburgh Steelers practice facility to object to the team signing of Michael Vick. Four women stood behind a green fence across the street from the team's Southside facility holding various signs, including one that read, "First Ben, now Vic, what next?" And in relative terms, man, you know, it's kind of being built up, I believe, by the media as this huge, huge story and this outrage about Michael Vick. And, you know, there's a handful of people once again outside of the Steelers practice facility. But they actually have this petition that they came up with. And right now, as the last I checked, they had over 15,000 signatures of people mad at the Pittsburgh Steelers and asking them, you know, to get rid of Mike Vick and, I guess, tear up his contract. I don't know how the hell that worked. And in relative terms, man, I don't think this is that big of an outrage. It kind of comes across as a big outrage. because it's on TV and they're going to highlight the people that are mad. But I'm really anxious to see, and I'm not going to get into back into my thoughts about all of the Michael Vick hate and this, that, and the other, because there's no real need to do that. I did that yesterday, and go back and check out yesterday's show if you want to hear my thoughts on the whole thing. But in relative terms, man, I don't think cats are going to, like, boycott or not use their tickets that are Pittsburgh Steelers fans. I think there's an initial jolt, and there's an initial backlash that a team is going to face and has faced over the last couple of years, and you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show. But I don't think at the end of the day, if you're a Steelers fan, and you might be mad at Mike Vick, and that's your prerogative, that's your right, I understand it totally. I don't understand why at some point over 8-9 years you don't forgive, but hey, that's fine, that's you. But I don't think cats are not going to show up to games, realistically. Now, these ladies that they had are part of this protest group, they had mentioned, I saw the video, they had mentioned how they aren't going to use their tickets. They've ruined their season because they're just not going to go to the games. And I'm sure there's a couple of people that are that emphatic about this and that much disgusted with the Steelers for signing Vic. But, you know, in a stadium that can hold 80,000 people, what? We're talking about, what, 20 people? You know, at the end of the day? So, once again, at the end of the day, I don't think this is going to be that big of a deal. I don't think this is going to turn into that big of a deal. It just amazes me. I mean, to sum it up, it just amazes me how mad people can get at a particular topic, at a particular subject. Life is too short, man. Seriously. And I promise I wouldn't get back into my thoughts on it. You know my thoughts on it. The man went to jail. I mean, hard, cold, real criminals jail. The man went to jail. What he did was wrong. What he did was wrong. And it was offensive. And it was terribly bad and stupid. You know? How could you do something like that? I've never understood that. But at the end of the day, the man went to jail for years. Paid retribution. Paid back his quote-unquote debt to society. Made amends, has gone on this like circuit type thing where he goes and speaks at animal shelters and talks about what he did and how wrong it was and how sorry he was. The man has probably said on record, sorry, I don't know, 500, 600, 700 times. What more do you want the man to do? I don't understand that part of it. What more do you want this guy to do where you say, you know, he's made retribution? I just don't understand it, man. So what are your thoughts on that, man? If you're a Steeler fan out there, and you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show, if you're a Steeler fan and this bothers you, or if you're a Steeler fan and it doesn't bother you, but you've had conversations with other Steeler fans and seen the comments made by other Steeler fans that are just appalled by this whole thing, I want to hear your thoughts, man. I want to hear your thoughts on the Spreaker chat, or I want you to give me a call at 404-382-0338. You can also email me at Doug@thedougstewartshow.com. What are your thoughts about this whole thing, man? And once again, the same thing went down when he signed with the Philadelphia Eagles. The same thing went down to a lesser degree when he signed with the New York Jets. So once again, it's kind of like rolling down a hill. Yeah, there was a lot of outrage when he first got out of jail, and a lot of people talked about, and you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show, a lot of people talked about, you know, not giving him a second chance. He shouldn't be allowed to play in the NFL. So getting out of jail, you being an ex-convict and playing for the Philadelphia Eagles, you know, the story was fresher. But that was, what, 5 years ago? Was that 5 years ago? And then now, you know, a couple years have passed and he signed with the New York Jets. And then there was a little bit less outrage. And then now we're talking 5 years later. I mean, you read some of these chat boards, man. People are mad. And the best word I could probably come up with is appalled. 5-6 years after the fact. Wow. I mean, it's kind of like an eye-opener to the depth of how mad people are and how much hate exists and how much people are unwilling to forgive. It's an eye-opener. Like, if you didn't see it before, if you didn't understand the depth of how much people won't forgive, like, this is like the perfect example of that. So what are your thoughts on that, man? When we get back from the break, let's talk a little bit about Derrick Rose. He's in the news, and I also get into some of your chat And we will break down some of these birthdays today on the Doug Stewart Show. Yeah, what are your thoughts on that, man? 404-382-0338. When we get back, birthdays and some of your chat. This is the Doug Stewart Show. You've been thinking about starting that online store, right? And you do know e-commerce makes billions a year. That's right. I said billions with a B, okay? A B. Well, just do it and do it right with my friends at AmeriCommerce. AmeriCommerce is an easy-to-use tool to sell anything online, on Facebook, and through mobile phones. Over 100,000 merchants and website owners have chosen AmeriCommerce to handle their stores and customers. They have the most in-depth features in the industry, which include multiple storefronts, website management from one console, a Facebook shopping application, a mobilized, optimized website, and much more. Don't let eBay, Amazon, and Zappos get all the money. Get your piece of the pie, too. Click on their banner link on thedougstewartshow.com or the app link for more details. First of all, thank you for listening to The Doug Stewart Show. Now, if you've been listening for a while, you know that we've grown exponentially over the first couple of months. Whether that's listens, whether that's followers, we're blowing up, and you could be a part of it. If you have a company out there and you like to promote on The Doug Stewart Show, we'd love to partner with you. Here's what you do. Email me at Doug@thedougstewartshow.com. Once again, that's Doug@thedougstewartshow.com. Whether that's locally, regionally, or nationally, we can get the word out. What you're talking about is middle-aged dudes that love sports and love exciting sports talk. Once again, email me at Doug@thedougstewartshow.com. That's Doug@thedougstewartshow.com, and we will put you out there, all right? That's Doug@thedougstewartshow.com. Let's do some business. Yes! Fantasy sports fans are winning huge cash prizes every day at DraftKings.com, America's favorite place to play daily fantasy sports. Daily fantasy means no season-long commitments. Play whenever you want. Just pick your sport and draft your team. It's like a new season every time you play, so you're never stuck with the same players. Last year, $300 million were won at DraftKings.com, and you could be next to win big. Go to DraftKings.com now and enter promo code STU to play for free. That's STU for free entry now at DraftKings.com. Also, if you use promo code STU, DraftKings will match your initial deposit up to $600. Deposit $600, play with $1,200. DraftKings.com, promo code STU.
Stewies, what's up? Tree here to talk about your home security and the security experts at Strickland Security. Everything the team at Strickland Security does is focused around increasing the security of your home, protecting your family, and your business. Most home security companies, especially the larger ones, want to sell you a cookie-cutter alarm system that maximizes their profits but not your security. The team at Strickland Security will install a customized alarm system that meets your budget and your security needs. This Atlanta-based company is here to solve all of your security problems. Whether you need your alarm system repaired, surveillance cameras installed, or your door locks replaced, Strickland Security is the solution. Don't wait. Call the experts at Strickland Security today. For more information, go to their website at StricklandSecurity.com or give them a call now at 800-422-9075. That's 800-422-9075 and tell them Tree sent you.
Yeah. We in the house for the 93 shot. MC8, you know what I'm saying? Ain't no faking a funk. And ain't nothing but a Compton thing.
One of my favorite movies of all time. I mean, I saw it last night on one of the black stations, BET TV1. Menace of Society. If you're from the West Coast, man, does MC8 have another song other than this one? This is his only work that I know. I mean, being on the East Coast my whole life. But I absolutely love this track right here. Now my pops is gone and that ain't no good. Got to follow That might be the, if you talk about theme songs for that era of what we witnessed in California, you know, the Crips, the Bloods, and all of the hood movies that came out during the late 80s, early 90s, Boys in the Hood, Menace to Society, Colors, all of the movies. This might be the theme song if you wanted to encapsulate all that, what was going on in L.A., Compton, and all of those places. This song might be the song that kind of encapsulates the whole thing. Like, this would be the theme song for late 80s, early 90s, Compton. Even more so than some of the Dr. Dre stuff. When I hear this song, I think of that era. Welcome back to the Doug Stewart Show. This is a Throwback Thursday. Here's your little Throwback Thursday talk just now. The number to the show is 404-382-0338. You can also email me at Doug, thedougstewartshow.com. Getting your thoughts on this Mike Vick hate. Also in a second, we're going to talk about Derrick Rose, man. Some accusations about this young man, and I don't want to believe them, but we'll get into that conversation here in a second. 404-382-0338. You can also email me at Doug, thedougstewartshow.com. But the easy way, which I'm going to get into here in a second, is the chat on Spreaker.com. And I read chat all day long. Yeah. So today, celebrating their 28th birthday, is Darren McFadden, running back now for the Dallas Cowboys. Happy birthday to him. Can't get right. Cannot get right. And this is probably a better place than any than to talk about another major injury in the NFL. Junior Gallette, the defensive end, outside linebacker for the Washington Redskins, who played his career before this in New Orleans, tore his Achilles. So he is done for the year. He's done. And just like, and so that's a tough loss, and still more conversation about, you know, training camps and how these guys are training. Is it too much or is it not enough? And it seems like there's been a rash of major injuries to some of the most prominent players in the game. But this dude was a beast. I mean, a beast for many years down in New Orleans. Troubled pass. You ever seen that video of Junior Gallette, like at a spring break type event on the beach? And supposedly it's Junior Gallette, but he's saying it's not him. And like there's this melee fight on the beach, and there's this dude that looked just like Junior Gallette at a glance. It was this dude that had his belt, took his belt off, and was like fending off people that were trying to come at him with this belt. And he was like whooping fools on the beach. And the Saints released him, and there's a whole controversy about that. Once again, he has an attorney, and he's saying, no, that wasn't him. But a lot of witnesses says, no, it was dude. So there's a lot of backstory on that. But this injury to him is going to put him on the sidelines for a year. As well as you've seen a ton of rashes, rash injuries this preseason. Kelvin Benjamin, Jordy Nelson, and this whole conversation about injuries. And if you talk about Darren McFadden, he has never been healthy in the NFL. The other day, and you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show, we were talking about Sam Bradford, and I was trying to make the point, or I was making the point, that being able to stay on the field, you know, and being healthy and being available for teams, that's an asset. That is. And, you know, just like some guys are faster than the others, some guys just stay healthy. They have the ability and the God-given talent, have you, to stay healthy. If you think back to some of the greatest players ever, I mean, if you talk about guys that get into the Hall of Fame, a lot of it is because they were healthy and they were available to play. You talk about Curtis Martin. He was never healthy. You talk about some of the greatest players ever. Barry Sanders, I always bring up. Emmitt Smith, Troy Aikman, Michael Irvin. Some of the greatest players ever. If you think about it, most of the time, those guys were available. They were able to play. And Sam Bradford can't stay healthy. So it's kind of he kind of takes a nick as far as his relevancy and his legacy because he just can't stay on the field. Same thing with Darren McFadden, man. Same thing with Darren McFadden. Actually being able to play is a talent. We always talk about it and joke about it. Me and my brother, we've always had these knee injuries and little pulls and hamstrings. I don't know if it's something with our diet or something with the physiology of the Stewart boys or what. But we just could never stay healthy. My brother's career ended from a groin injury. And he'd work on it and rehab and come back and he'd hurt it again. And same thing with me. I hurt my knee my senior year of high school, and then I hurt it again my sophomore year in college. So staying on the field is a big asset, man. And Darren McFadden, he's 28 years old. If you're a Cowboy fan and you expect anything out of Darren McFadden, you are sadly mistaken. And I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Yeah. If you get production, if you get 16 games production out of Darren McFadden, consider it a blessing. Consider it catching lightning in a bottle. Because this ninja ain't never been healthy his entire career in the NFL. From Mace, rapper Mace, turns 40 years old today. Happy birthday to him. Now, is he still doing the ministry thing? Or is he totally just excavated himself from that? Tree, I'm asking you. I mean, you the sanctified person on the show.
Oh, my God. I don't follow other alleged sanctified people.
Well,
stop calling me that. It makes me feel some kind of way.
And you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show. I mean, I thought when I came and met you one time, we had a business meeting, you had on the front seat of your car Sanctified USA. So I thought that you keep track of ministers, just like we keep baseball cards as kids. I thought you kept track of ministers and where they go and what church they at now. I don't know. I'm asking.
Yeah, I don't know, but I'll actually look into that. We could probably even get him on the show because he probably ain't doing nothing else.
And you know what? I actually am a fan of Mace. If you've heard me talk, I'm a fan of Mace. I'm a fan of Puff. I'm a fan of that whole Bad Boy era. In the mid-90s. I'm a fan of that, man. Whenever I hear that music, whenever I hear Puff and Mace, Can't Nobody Hold Me Down, I mean, I start to, you know, do my little dance or whatnot. You know, it makes me feel kind of good. But so it was great to see when they did that Bad Boy reunion thing, I think, on the BET Awards or whatever, and Mace came out there. Clearly, Mace has lost a step. He's put on like 20 pounds, it looks like, to me. Face looking real fat. Face looking real fat and chubby, but that was real cool, man. That was good stuff, man. So Mace turns 40 years old today. He's in the 40 club now, and also today celebrating a birthday. Ooh, I should have had the Pee Wee's music ready, the Pee Wee dance. Pee Wee Herman, aka Paul Rubens, turns. You don't have the birthday down here, Tree. Was it 60? How much? 63.
Yes, apologies.
Pee Wee Herman turned 63 years old today. Old pervert. Pee Wee's Playhouse. You remember Large Marge? Pee Wee's Playhouse, Large Marge, the meanest lady driving a truck in America. He turned 63 years old today. Happy birthday to him, man. You know what happened a couple of years later. With that whole thing, he had porn. He wasn't actually trying to have sex with kids or nothing like that, right? He had this porn, like, library or something? What was it?
Well, I mean, by those standards back then, it was blasphemous.
Yeah,
but
it was
now,
big.
Now, that's kind of mild manner. He was like the Jared of that day.
Right, right.
Because he was a kid. Pee Wee's Playhouse was a kid's thing.
Right. And relative,
kinda, on HBO with a lot of innuendos.
In relative terms to what this joker from the Subway commercials, Jared Fogle did a couple of, or has been convicted of, what Pee Wee Herman did. Paul Rubens did is really small time. I mean, he didn't do nothing. He didn't have sex with no little kids, as far as we know. What he did, oh, I know what it was. He revealed himself in public. Was that what it was? Yeah. And the reason I said it like that, and you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show, remind me when we get back from the break to talk about my story about a dude revealing himself.
Oh, Lord, I knew we couldn't go. Not well, 1 week.
When we get
Come
back,
on, Uncle Dougie.
When we get back from the break, and I'm not going to use any names. So, if you're listening to the show and it was you I'm talking about, I'm not going to use your name, folks. But when we get back from the break, I'm going to talk about a story where somebody I know very well revealed himself. Yeah. Don't go away. This is the Doug Stewart Show. That's what we do around here. That's the type of stuff we do. First of all, thank you for listening to the Doug Stewart Show. Now, if you've been listening for a while, you know that we've grown exponentially over the first couple of months. Whether that's listens, whether that's followers, we're blowing up, and you can be a part of it. If you have a company out there and you'd like to promote on the Doug Stewart Show, we'd love to partner with you. Here's what you do. Email me at Doug@thedougstewartshow.com. Once again, that's Doug@thedougstewartshow.com. Whether that's locally, regionally, or nationally, we can get the word out. What you're talking about is middle-aged dudes that love sports and love exciting sports talk. Once again, email me at Doug@thedougstewartshow.com. That's Doug@thedougstewartshow.com, and we will put you out there, all right? That's Doug@thedougstewartshow.com. Let's do some business. Yes!
National Debt Relief is one of the country's largest and most reputable debt settlement companies, made up of energetic individuals who are passionate about helping thousands of Americans with debt relief. Most importantly, we're all about helping our customers through a tough financial time in their lives with education and individual customer service. We're dedicated to helping individuals and families rid their lives of burdensome debt. Specializing in debt settlement, and they've also negotiated settlements for thousands of creditor and collection accounts. Providing clients with both expertise and proven results, this means helping customers in time of hardship to get out of debt with the least possible cost. It can also mean conducting financial consultations, educating the customer, and recommending the appropriate solution. Core Services offer debt settlement as an alternative. I repeat, alternative to bankruptcy, credit counseling, and debt consolidation. National Debt Relief is your number one advocate group to help you reestablish financial stability as quickly as possible. So give us a call at 844-828-4975. Again, that's 844-828-4975, and work it out.
At Ticket Liquidator, we believe you should have access to the experiences you want to be a part of. Since 2003, Ticket Liquidator has been connecting buyers and sellers with the most sought-after and often sold-out events across the country. Ticket Liquidator's nationwide network gives you access to one of the largest online inventories of sports, theater, and concert tickets, with prices lower than most companies in other markets. And our security policies are solid, so you can buy with absolute confidence. More tickets, better service, and lower prices, so you can witness the best entertainment, culture, and sports events worldwide. At Ticket Liquidator, we know that seeing a legend bring down the house or watching your team win the championship is about more than a ticket. It's about being there. For all your sports and entertainment ticket needs, call us at 855-638-3034. Again, that's 855-638-3034.
Right, this is my daily play my favorite song. Speaking of Puffy, this is my daily play my favorite song segment. Welcome back to the Doug Stewart Show. Let's go. Let's go. Let's do it, Puff. Yes, sir. I should have been on Periscope right now. Doing my Puffy dance. Hey, welcome back to the Doug Stewart Show. This is a Throwback Thursday.
You look crazy, like you're having a seizure up in here.
Thank you so much. All right, so I'm going to get to this Derrick Rose story here in a second. I'm going to start reading some of your chat. But before we went to the break, I started telling the story, or I was about to tell this story about cats revealing themselves. This is no lie. This is not a lie, and you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show. Back in, what year was that? I'm going to guess this was like 2000 or something like that. Maybe 99 or something like that. So, you know, we're in Atlanta. Me and my brother, we're two country boys. We live here in the city, back in my hometown. They call Atlanta the big city. And they used to call New York that, but now they call Atlanta the big city. And so what happens is whenever people from my hometown come here, they always expected us to be like tour guides. And the number one thing they want to do, and you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show, is they want us to take them to the shoe modeling establishment, right? I mean, it's Atlanta. That's what we know for, Nikki's and Magic City and this, that, and the other. So this particular weekend, one of our homeboys came to town, and so he's like, man, take me to Magic City. I heard all about Magic City, this, that, and the other. You know, we country people for the most part. So we're not used to this stuff around here. We've never seen, like, naked ladies. We've seen naked ladies before at strip clubs, like in Charleston, but they wear them pasty things. They half naked. They can't take off their bottoms. It's not like Atlanta where you literally see, like, spleens and kidneys and all of that type stuff. So it's kind of a shock. So we take this guy. This is not a lie. I swear to you, God, before God is my witness. We take this guy. He's a grown man now. We're older now. We're probably in our mid-30s or something like that, early 30s. We take this guy to Magic City, and we're just sitting there chilling, and everything and is going good, and we're feeling it. We got a couple of drinks, and then all of a sudden, you know, I take my eye off of the dude, or I go to the bathroom or something like that, or I go to the stage to tip the ladies. I mean, hell, they working. And I turn around, and security, like, rushes my homeboy that just came into town. And they're, like, grabbing him by his collar and pulling him. They're dragging his ass out the club. So it's me, Ryan, and, like, two other dudes in the club from my hometown that live here in Atlanta. So it's, like, five or six of us. So we run over. And, you know how bouncers are. They just looking to pop a cap at somebody's ass. But Ryan has a relationship with these dudes, kind of, sort of. You know, he went to Georgia Tech, so he's a regular. All right? And we stop and we grab them. And, like, what's going on? What's going on? What's going on? And the dude, one of Ryan's boys that's a bouncer there, he comes over to the side. He says, man, he got to go. He got to go. He got to go. Ryan's like, wait, what did he do? What did he do? The dude says, look, he got to go. He got to go, Stu, because he revealed himself. So there's like this look of puzzlement, I guess that's a word, on Ryan's face. And we look at each other like, what the hell you mean he revealed himself? Stu, that's what he did. He revealed himself. And so there's no stopping this. They actually throw us all out of the club. They throw him out of the club as he's got to go. They throw him out of the club and they say, you guys got to go too because y'all with him. So we get outside and we grab this guy and we say, like, man, what the hell happened? What does he mean you revealed yourself? And he looks, he's like, man, the girl was dancing, man, and I took my thing out. You did what, Ninja? You did what? Yeah, man, I took my thing out. I didn't know we couldn't do that. What the hell you mean you didn't know you couldn't do that, Ninja? What, are you crazy? Yeah. He revealed himself in Magic City. So every time we see this dude to this day, you know, we just bring that up, man. And it's a laugh fest. Like, man, are you really serious? Are you that country to think that you can reveal yourself in public? Well, I mean, what type of perv are you? And he didn't know, and I really don't think he's a real perv to that degree. Let me say this, and I haven't given his name or anything like that. I don't think he's a real perv. I just think that he was ignorant, you know? I just thought that, hey, I mean, there's women here. Are they naked? Maybe I should get naked too. That was his line of thinking. His first time he'd ever been to Atlanta, you know, he's from the country. We don't see things like this. Back where I'm from, and whenever I'm in a scenario where a woman's naked and she's flirting with me, you know, she's smiling at me. And usually at that point when I'm back home in Monk's Corner, I take my thing out. And so it was absolutely horrible. Stu, he gotta go. He revealed himself. What? Oh, boy. Oh, my gosh. Oh, my God. 404-382-0338 is the number to the show. Tree is shaking her head profusely right now. Yeah, that's a real-life story. That's a real-life story. Yes, Tree? What? What?
I mean, did his mama not teach him better than that?
But his mama never taught him.
This is a grown up.
His mama never taught him strip club etiquette.
And you got the nerve to talk about Detroit. And you keep coming up with these crazy ass stories from your hometown.
And trust me, that's a true story. I mean, I don't make up none of this stuff. That's a real true story, man. 404-382-0338 is the number to the show. This is the Doug Stewart Show. Let me read some of your chat, man. Thank you for all of the chat. I'm starting to see some comments. And I'm sure if you can relate, if you're a dude listening to the show, the Doug Stewart Show, if you're a dude listening to the show and you're from a small town and you move to a big city, your homeboys come to town, you're supposed to be the tour guy, right? You feel me, right? And they want to do everything. And you probably had this scenario happen to you to a smaller degree, I hope, where you took your homeboys to a real, real strip club, not a play strip club, a real one. And the look of amazement on their face is just classic. It's just classic. From Kim Jane, she says, congrats to MV7. F the haters. They don't pay your bills. From Bussa. Once Mike Vick scores that first touchdown, all the hate will go away, I hope, ? Dollars and cents in the chat room says, F these racist, Bible-thumping, ass Steelers fans. Follow the team, not the name on the back of the jersey. They come and go. No, I don't have a problem. And I'm not even saying that this is a race-type situation. I don't have a problem with you being mad or feeling some type of way about a guy that's done something wrong. My entire point about this, yeah, if you are a person that loves animals, I love animals, we got a dog. If you're a person that loves animals, yeah, I would feel very offended. I would be mad. I would think that Mike Vick was disgusting and revolting when all of this stuff went down. But after you do a couple of years in the pokey, you've done all the things and walked the straight and narrow for not a year or two or three or four. 5 or 6 years, I mean, at some point, you gotta forgive. That's all I'm saying. That's all I'm saying. From Eugene Jackson, damn, Derrick Rose, this better be a money grab. Damn, Derrick, I'm going to talk about that story coming up here in a second with Derrick Rose. Thorny Switch, Doug, you have to stop with this teasing. Yeah, what teasing? What are you talking about? From Al Thompson, I hope it's the third hour, but what if it's a third hour of Doug murdering the hits? What do you mean, murdering the hits, sir? You're so funny. Speaking of which, if I get the opportunity today, man, I might sing something for y'all. I mean, if y'all act nice, I just might sing something for y'all. 404-382-0338 is the number to the show. You can email me at doug@thedougshowshow.com. From Rel Scott, third hour or return of Ryan. I have no idea what you're talking about, sir. From Grego. Ryan said he has a lot to say on Periscope yesterday. If Ryan comes back, he better not stop Doug from singing. Thank you, Grego. Ryan, that'll never happen. And I'm not saying any of what you're talking about in this Ryan stuff is actually the case. But don't forget, that's my little brother. He might be bigger than me in stature, but that's still my little brother. And he or nobody on this earth can stop me from doing what the good Lord has put me here to do, and that's sing. Nobody can. Not even my big brother. That's my little brother. Ryan can do that. So that ain't gonna happen. Don't worry, fella. Don't worry. Let's see. From our Run CNC, Moby Dick is co-hosting a third hour. We don't know. From Grego, Tree gonna call HR on you, Doug. Why she gonna call HR on me? What did I say, HR?
That damn asking me what is truffle, but did I look it up?
Yeah.
Now this nonsense. Don't bring your cousin or whoever it was up in here.
No, I didn't say it was a cousin. I said it was a friend of mine, a homeboy of mine. There ain't no damn HR around here. How about that? I'm the HR. Yeah. Call me Human Resources Doug. Any complaints you have about any of the subject matter on this show, she going to have to come talk to me. From Vince Wright, Larry's office, truffle butter. From P Cola 3, no to truffle butter. The whole thing is disgusting. As a matter of fact, I'm going to stop even saying it. I love that song. I love that beat on that song. But these kids are just nasty in 2015. Yeah. Yeah. All right, when we get back from the break, man, hour number two of the Doug Stewart Show. And let's talk about this Derrick Rose story. Lightweight, we'll talk about it. I got a theory on probably how the whole thing went down, allegedly. Don't go away. This is the Doug Stewart Show.
National Debt Relief is one of the country's largest and most reputable debt settlement companies, made up of energetic individuals who are passionate about helping thousands of Americans with debt relief. Most importantly, we're all about helping our customers through a tough financial time in their lives with education and individual customer service. We're dedicated to helping individuals and families rid their lives of burdensome debt. Specializing in debt settlement, and they've also negotiated settlements for thousands of creditor and collection accounts. Providing clients with both expertise and proven results, this means helping customers in time of hardship to get out of debt with the least possible cost. It can also mean conducting financial consultations, educating the customer, and recommending the appropriate solution. Core Services offer debt settlement as an alternative. I repeat, alternative to bankruptcy, credit counseling, and debt consolidation. National Debt Relief is your number one advocate group to help you reestablish financial stability as quickly as possible. So give us a call at 844-828-4975. Again, that's 844-828-4975, and work it out.
The best of the Doug Stewart Show.
So I'm probably six. So Jesse Bryant rolls by, and I remember it like it was yesterday. He rolls by in his truck, and for some reason, something in my mind says, pick up a rock and throw it at Jesse. And I hit his truck. And not only did I hit his truck, it was a damn good throw and aim, because it hit his windshield and it cracked his windshield. So he stops and jumps out of the truck. I don't think anybody saw me, but he jumps out and, Isaac, so-and-so, your grandson hit my truck with a rock. They had a little conversation. I'm like, oh, man, this is bad. And sure enough, my grandfather walks up and sees this nick on the windshield. And Jesse rolls away, and I know I'm in trouble. My daddy not around, my mother not around. And my grandfather reaches down, and this is, God is my witness, strike me down right here. My grandfather reaches down and pulls off a branch from a rose bush. Yes, just drags his arm and pulls off the leaves. Thorns are still applied to said switch. You get your ass whipped with a switch is bad enough, but a thorny switch? Oh my gosh. So he commences to busting my ass with a thorny switch. Yes. And you know I was marked up from head to toe. Now, that's probably child abuse. Not saying that what Adrian Peterson didn't do was child abuse either, but that was child abuse. That's a deadly weapon. And this is no lie. You're listening to the Doug Stewart Show.
Fantasy sports fans are winning huge cash prizes every day at DraftKings.com, America's favorite place to play daily fantasy sports. Daily fantasy means no season-long commitments. Play whenever you want. Just pick your sport and draft your team. It's like a new season every time you play, so you're never stuck with the same players. Last year, $300 million were won at DraftKings.com, and you could be next to win big. Go to DraftKings.com now and enter promo code STU to play for free. That's STU for free entry now at DraftKings.com. Also, if you use promo code STU, DraftKings will match your initial deposit up to $600. Deposit $600, play with $1,200. DraftKings.com, promo code STU.
Hour number two, baby. Yes, yes. Welcome back to the Doug Stewart Show. Throwback Thursday. Thank you for joining your folk, man. I really do appreciate it. Man, big news on the horizon. Big news on the horizon, man. Stay tuned. Big things popping. The weekend of September 26th, man. Come on to Atlanta. If you live in Atlanta, make sure you hang out with me the entire weekend long, celebrating the one-year anniversary of the Doug Stewart Show. Get all the details about all the parties and the golf tournament and viewing parties and whatnot at tdssweekend.eventbrite.com. If you want to play in the golf tournament, registration ends for that September 11th. So you got to register for the golf tournament by September 11th, all right? And you get all the information, once again, from tdssweekend.eventbrite.com. Longest drive, closest to the pin. We're going to put together a nice-sized skin pot. Yes, sir. For my golfers out there. It's crazy. So tdssweekend.eventbrite.com. Come celebrate 1 year with your boy. 404-382-0338 is the number to the show. This is the Doug Stewart Show. Getting your thoughts on these injuries in the NFL. Also getting your thoughts on the uproar with Mike Vick signing with the Pittsburgh Steelers. And also, man, this is a story that's kind of leaked out, I guess is the best way to put it. It's not being reported by, the big boys, the Puppet Factory, which is ESPN for new listeners. So it's not being reported really right now by the Puppet Factory or Sports Illustrated or Yahoo or anybody like that. TMZ, what's the other one that we saw it on, Tree?
The New York Post.
Well, the New York Post has just come out with this. That's probably the most reputable site. And really, we need to stop saying and grouping TMZ and non-reputable media entities, because usually 9 times out of 10, they're on top of it before everybody else. But Derrick Rose is being sued by a woman who claims the NBA superstar and two of his friends drugged and gang raped her. The woman, identified only as Jane Doe, says she and Rose dated from 2011 to 2013. During that time, Rose allegedly tried to pressure her to masturbate in front of him, allow him to have sex with her friends, and engage in group sex with strangers, all of which she says she refused. Rose's accuser says the two continued to date until August 2013, when Rose and two friends, Ryan Allen and Randall Hampton, who is Rose's personal manager, invited her to Rose's Beverly Hills house. She says there they slipped a drug into her drink with the aim of raping her. The plaintiff says she escaped the house with a friend, but later that night, Rose and her friends broke into her apartment and gang raped her. What? Now, once again, and you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show. Once again, this is all speculation. We don't know any of the details of this type of thing, of this particular story. This whole story really, really sounds hard to believe, especially 2 years after the fact. Let me just say that. 2 years after the fact, now you're making these accusations, and you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show. Tree, go ahead. What are your thoughts?
Don't do that, because I got on that train, or no pun. Let me start over. Don't do that. I got on that ship about William, Mr. Cosby.
Right.
Because I was certain that it was just so long.
Right. Well, once again, I'm not saying he didn't or he did do this. What I'm saying is, based on the details, the little bit of details that we have right now, and this is the same attitude I took towards Bill Cosby when all of that information came out. And if we get more information to the opposite, then once again, I'll keep it real. But right now, from these details that I got, this doesn't jive, man. She claims she waited for 2 years to file the suit because she was ashamed and embarrassed of what happened and concerned her conservative family would find out. She wants unspecified damages. So it sounds like she's not concerned about, just from what I'm reading here. Once again, and you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show, it's not so much concerned about him going to jail and paying for, raping her, drugging her and raping her, gang raping her. It sounds like a money thing. She wants unspecified damages. Why is it unspecified? If it's you want to see this ninja go to jail because he took your nootsie, you want people to know. You want people to know what you want. And you want to know what retribution you desire as well. So, once again, we don't know any of the details more so than what we have in front of us right now. And once again, TMZ is reporting this. The New York Times is gone with it as well early this morning. So we'll keep our eye on the story.
And now the Washington It's the New York Post and now the Washington Post. Again, I'm not saying it makes it valid.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
We're just reporting the news.
Yeah, yeah. And something that I always think about, and you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show, something I always think about whenever these stories happen is, or come out, is why. And I know in this day and time, man, seemingly over the last couple of years, like this whole Molly thing is kind of glorified and is glamorized in music and these rap songs and whatever, man. And this whole Molly and like Molly is like supposedly cool. No, it's a date rape drug. At the end of the day, it might have a cool, cute name or whatever, but the purpose is to get somebody out of their mind so you can get that nootsie. And we got to change that. We got to change that mindset about that whole culture, man, and that whole Molly and all of that stuff, man, because that is crazy. I'm not saying that's the case with Derrick Rose, and I'm hoping that's not the case. Just like I hope that wasn't the case with Bill Cosby, and I hope that wasn't the case with Darren Chopper. I'm hoping that this isn't the case with Derrick Rose. 404-382-0338 is the number to the show. You can email me at Doug@thedougstewartshow.com. In about 20 minutes, we're going to talk about the Houston Texans, who got a lot to look forward to this year in the NFL. From the 47th problem, Tree, I really need to get my business advertised on TDSS, so I just go to Fiverr to get this done? Yeah, yeah, man, that's all you do. Go to Fiverr.com. We've got all the gigs listed out there. We've got the gig where we'll broadcast your show on the network. We've got the gig where we'll do voiceovers. We've got the gig where we'll promote your company on the show. We'll do social media advertising. All starting at just $5. Yes, Fiverr.com, and just search The Doug Stewart Show. From Scotty, that Derrick Rose ish is a witch hunt. She waited 2 years only to file a civil suit. Yes, exactly what I was just saying. Blackmail shakedown gone wrong. From Bussa, Doug, the main thing is the Steeler ownership. They support African-American players and coaches. They started the Rooney Rule. You're exactly right. The ownership, you know, clearly is in support of black people in the NFL and having opportunities in the NFL administration-wise, coaching-wise. There's one thing you can't say about the Rooney family is that they support black people, African-American people in pro football. From Felpay, I think it may have something to do with Vic playing with the Eagles after prison. Of course, those Steeler fans hate Vic. To them, he is a black eagle who killed dogs. Dollars and cents. Is the Eagles and the Steelers, is that the rivalry? Obviously, both of them in the state of Pennsylvania, I guess so. From I guess maybe in my mind, I didn't think it was that much of a rivalry because one's AFC and one's NFC. But they are in the same state, so I guess so. From Dollars and Cents, what's the number, Stewies, I want to call in as the only Steeler fan in this Mickey Ficky? The number to the show is 404-382-0338, man. I think I've only said it since we started the show back in September last year, I don't know, 25,000 times at least. 404-382-0338. From Sluggo, it's not about the dogs at all. They just hate ninjas getting any opportunity, especially a second one. Kwasikoto Haduchu, I think I said that right. Some people just looking for something to protest. Dollars and Cents, Tree, I have season tickets for the Steelers games. I'd like to call in. Dollars and Cents, call in, bruh. 404-382-0338. From Sandman, let Johnny Manziel do some ish like Mike Vick, and I bet you see a bunch of welcome back signs when he gets out of jail. I wonder how many black people signed that petition yesterday. Zero. I'm sure there probably were some black people that love animals and feel this type of way. From Eugene Jackson, the only repeat offender in Pittsburgh is Ben Big Ben, but he is forgiven. Which, you know, I just like I've forgiven Mike Vick and hopes him nothing but success, I've forgiven Big Ben. But why is it that people, you know, seem to be okay with Big Ben? And not only that, Big Ben, like my man just said, was a repeat offender. You know, paid chicks off to shut up and be quiet about this story for the most part. From Dobby, people feel like that man shouldn't be able to make his lucrative living because of his past mistakes. From Thorny Switch, I love dogs. I buy my little man clothes, etc. However, Vic served his time and is on the right track. These people have no lives and need to get a job. From Sluggo, Vic is no more washed up than any other backup quarterback in the league, to include the bum we saw yesterday, Rex Grossman. Yeah. From Ronald Cameron, Colors was good, though. The cops were dead wrong killing old dude while he was handing his business. Colors, I talked a little bit earlier about some of the classic hood movies from the late 80s and early 90s a little bit earlier. I mentioned my affinity for Straight Up Menace by MC8. It's probably the backdrop song of that era. From Vince Wright, so what do y'all think of Dr. Dre's album Compton? I talked about it. I bought it the first day it came out. It's good, but it ain't chronic good. It ain't Dr. Dre old school good. I mean, it's good. The music is good, I think. But it's not late 80s, early 90s NWA, Snoop Dogg, Death Row good. It's not that good. All right, we get back from the break, man. More of your chat. This is the Doug Stewart Show.
National Debt Relief is one of the country's largest and most reputable debt settlement companies, made up of energetic individuals who are passionate about helping thousands of Americans with debt relief. Most importantly, we're all about helping our customers through a tough financial time in their lives with education and individual customer service. We're dedicated to helping individuals and families rid their lives of burdensome debt. Specializing in debt settlement, and they've also negotiated settlements for thousands of creditor and collection accounts. Providing clients with both expertise and proven results, this means helping customers in time of hardship to get out of debt with the least possible cost. It can also mean conducting financial consultations, educating the customer, and recommending the appropriate solution. Core Services offer debt settlement as an alternative. I repeat, alternative to bankruptcy, credit counseling, and debt consolidation. National Debt Relief is your number one advocate group to help you reestablish financial stability as quickly as possible. So give us a call at 844-828-4975. Again, that's 844-828-4975, and work it out.
The best of the Doug Stewart Show.
Give you the history on this Doug Stewart and Tree Taylor battle and trivia crack. We just started playing last week. We played three games. I won the first one in handily fashion. And then Tree has come along to beat me two times in a row. All right. Now, I blame Trivia Crack for asking me dumbass questions about romance comedies from the 1980s. That's who I blame. But she's won. And I got to give her credit. What?
I knew you were going to. Like, when you talk about women, Tree has come along.
It ain't got nothing to do with you being a woman. Wait. Did you just. What? Oh, my gosh. Did she just call me the N-word? Oh, damn. We made Doug Stewart's show history just now. As many times as I've almost uttered that term. You did it! And we don't have 7-second delay.
I'm fired.
You getting a BPA. You nominated for a Boiled Penis Award.
No!
Yes, you are. The first time in the Doug Stewart Show history, someone utters the N-word.
And you're sick of you.
You're listening to the Doug Stewart Show. good thing we, you know, on radio, traditional radio, the FCC be beating down my damn door right now. They're already looking for a reason to try to put me out of business. And you come up with this. Golly, Tree, you're better than that.
Bad girl is
poison.
At Ticket Liquidator, we believe you should have access to the experiences you want to be a part of. Since 2003, Ticket Liquidator has been connecting buyers and sellers with the most sought-after and often sold-out events across the country. Ticket Liquidator's nationwide network gives you access to one of the largest online inventories of sports, theater, and concert tickets, with prices lower than most companies in other markets. And our security policies are solid, so you can buy with absolute confidence. More tickets, better service, and lower prices, so you can witness the best entertainment, culture, and sports events worldwide. At Ticket Liquidator, we know that seeing a legend bring down the house or watching your team win the championship is about more than a ticket. It's about being there. For all your sports and entertainment ticket needs, call us at 855-638-3034. Again, that's 855-638-3034.
We'll be right back.
ladies and gentlemen.
If you're not stewing, what the hell are you doing? This is the Doug Stewart Show. And it's a throwback Thursday. In about 15 minutes, we are going to talk about the Houston Texans on the show, man, as well as continue with this chat on this throwback Thursday. Thank you so much for joining me. I really do appreciate it. I say thank you a lot because I really do mean it. I mean, I'm sincere. I'm very sincere about that, man. Thank you so much. You could be doing anything else. You're probably at your work, your boss riding your back, and you want a little bit of fun and talk about these sports and guy talk. And so that's what you get here on the Doug Stewart Show, and we do it like nobody else. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Tell somebody, though. I need you to pass the word. Let me go ahead and grab a call. Caller, thanks for calling the Doug Stewart Show. What's your name? Where you calling from? What you want to talk about?
Dollars and cents. What's up, baby? I'm in Kalamazoo, Michigan.
Dollars and cents. How you doing, man?
Yeah, I'm doing well. I'm doing well.
Now, what do you got? What you got for me, dollars and cents?
Yeah, so now I've been a Steelers fan, man. I'm 42, so damn near probably 30-some years, man. And if you look at it, they've had major issues with players like Dan Moore's getting busted with weed, Eric Green, Santonio Holmes, Harrison has had some domestic violence, Big Ben. You know, you had the Plaxico Burress. So, it's been – they've had issues there at Pittsburgh. So, majority of these people that are signing this this petition, you're talking about 15,000, Doug, they pretty much all white. So I know you didn't want to say it's not necessarily racing, but it really is. You're talking about that part of the territory, you know, Pittsburgh, West Virginia. It's a bunch of hillbilly slash, Bible-thumping racist people. And it's just sad because – they love Big Ben, and he got accused of rape, but obviously he didn't go to court. But,
right.
It's a situation where they're upset, with Michael Vick, but the man has paid his dues. And in matter of fact, the dude decided not to file for bankruptcy. He actually paid all his creditors back. What athlete does that?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So it's just a situation where, I think it's more of a race issue. They'll let go of my man Bell getting pulled over smoking weed by a police officer on a motorcycle on his way to the game, and then Blunt as well, but then they'll have an issue with Michael Vick, and he's a backup quarterback. So I just think it's stupid, man. All these damn Steelers fans need to, shut the hell up. And to be honest, it's ridiculous, Doug. I will say this. I'm not a huge Mike Tomlin fan. He's a good coach. He's a brother. I'm glad for that. But the rate of incidents with the penalty, the Steelers players have gone up tremendously with Tomlin, unfortunately. And also, you're talking about the penalties they've led the league in. Penalties, personal fouls, and undisciplined players. I think it's a situation. He's a player's coach. I think he's a great guy. But the brothers are not helping my man Tomlin out. If you look at pretty much all the damn ninjas on the team that get in trouble, it makes Tomlin look bad when, in fact, he is a good coach. And that's pretty much it, man. I appreciate you and the Stewies giving me these 2 hours of some laughter. And y'all have a good one. Thanks.
There he is. Appreciate the call, dollars and cents, 404-382-0338. And, what he's saying is his opinion, and he's right to a large degree. The Steelers have always had, man, cats with questionable character. And I think a lot of it's got to do with the players that they always sign and that they draft. They sign players that are just mean and nasty. And that will bite your face off type guys. Hannibal Lecter type guys. And the aggression that a lot of their players have, man, sometimes leads them in the wrong direction, especially a lot of the defensive players, Greg Lloyd and cats like that. Not that he's ever been in trouble, but I'm just talking about some of the aggression that Steelers players historically have had. This LaDainian Bell situation that's been happening for the last couple of years. Talented player, but always seeming to find himself in trouble. Yeah, and that's another thing he pointed out as well that's interesting. We're talking about a backup quarterback that may not even have a job after Gronkowski comes back from injury. I doubt that. I think Gronkowski is going to be ass out unless Vic has lost another two or three steps. You're not going to come back after a month after they seen Michael Vick in camp, especially if he's refreshed, okay, if he's good and ready to go. You're not going to come back and be Gronkowski and take back over that second, string quarterback position over Mike Vick. That's just not going to happen. You're not that good anyway. So we'll see, man. From Grego, I turn my nose up at clubs out of town where they wear pasties. I get right back in my car. I mentioned earlier about how it was a big thing, you know, coming from our town in Charleston. And I don't know if it's still the same now. In Charleston, they used to wear them pasties, and I think they used to, you couldn't take off your bottoms. And where was it at? I just thought about this, and you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show. I mentioned earlier about the story of my homeboy came to town and revealed himself in the club. I think we were in Jacksonville for the Super Bowl. Either we were in Jacksonville for the Super Bowl, or we were in Birmingham for the fraternity's national convention, the Conclave. And we went into this shoe modeling establishment, and the chicks were wearing pasties, and I was like, man, this is whack. Like, it really just, it turns me off. When I've been to, you know, Atlanta, when I've been to every, you know, shoe modeling establishment in the city of Atlanta for the last 20 years, this is my 20-year anniversary in the city, and I mean, I've seen it all. I mean, at the highest standards of all. It's just, you can't go into any other place in this country. The only other place that I go that I've been to where I was like, okay, yeah, they can rival what we do in Atlanta with that strip club game is in Miami at Rolex. At Rolex and what's the other spot? Kings and Queens, which they take it to an even higher level. And you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show. But that's it. Everywhere else is just like, you know, I go back home and my boys say, let's go to Charleston to this little dive little strip clubs and dive in the wall type strip clubs, man. And it's just not the same, man. It's just really just not the same. From so I'm with you on that, Grego. From the 47 problem, she took her thing out, so why can't he take his out and for free? Yeah, I'm telling you, that was his thing. His thing was, hell, she naked. So why can't I get naked? Why can't, you know, her things are out, exactly like my man said. Her things out, you know, so it stands to reason I can take mine out. No, man, you can't do that. You can't do that. No, 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 you cannot do that. From Texas Ty. What up, Texas Ty? Tree, don't act like these stories aren't gold. Well, these stories, thank you. I appreciate that, man. But the stories are true. I mean, these stories are real. John, the company man, hey, man, they have VIP for stuff like that. So I've been told. Yeah, yeah. What was it, Chris Rock that had that I think he had a comedy, stand-up comedy, a live comedy taped. And I think he named it No Sex in the Champagne Room. Remember that? Or there was a song or something like that. Yeah, not saying that I've ever tried to get sex in a champagne room, a.k.a. VIP room or private room or anything like that. No, not me. But from what I understand is they're going to make you think that you're going to get some sex in the champagne room, but you're not. You're not. From what I've heard, they threaten these chicks and like you're going to lose your job and you're not going to, you know, you're never going to be able to work in this town again. So they're going to go to the edge, you know, of y'all actually doing it, but you actually not. That's the best way I can put this. You actually not. You're not going to be able to put it in. That's an urban legend. That's an urban legend. To a large degree. Now, I'm sure there's some unscrupulous places in America where that type of thing goes down, but I don't know about those places. I've never been there. Yeah. 99% of the time, there is no sex in the champagne room. Yes, sir. All right, when we get back from the break, man, let's talk a little bit about the Houston Texans, and I'll continue reading your chat. This is the Doug Stewart Show. First of all, thank you for listening to the Doug Stewart Show. Now, if you've been listening for a while, you know that we've grown exponentially over the first couple of months. Whether that's listens, whether that's followers, we're blowing up and you could be a part of it. If you have a company out there and you like to promote on the Doug Stewart Show, we'd love to partner with you. Here's what you do. Email me at Doug@thedougstewartshow.com. Once again, that's Doug@thedougstewartshow.com. Whether that's locally, regionally, or nationally, we can get the word out. What you're talking about is middle-aged dudes that love sports and love exciting sports talk. Once again, email me at Doug@thedougstewartshow.com. That's Doug at thedougstewartshow.com, and we will put you out there, all right? That's Doug at thedougstewartshow.com. Let's do some business. Yes!
Helping thousands of Americans with debt relief. Most importantly, we're all about helping our customers through a tough financial time in their lives with education and individual customer service. We're dedicated to helping individuals and families rid their lives of burdensome debt. Specializing in debt settlement, and they've also negotiated settlements for thousands of creditor and collection accounts. Providing clients with both expertise and proven results, this means helping customers in time of hardship to get out of debt with the least possible cost. It can also mean conducting financial consultations, educating the customer, and recommending the appropriate solution. Core Services offer debt settlement as an alternative. I repeat, alternative to bankruptcy, credit counseling, and debt consolidation. National Debt Relief is your number one advocate group to help you reestablish financial stability as quickly as possible. So give us a call at 844-828-4975. Again, that's 844-828-4975, and work it out.
At Ticket Liquidator, we believe you should have access to the experiences you want to be a part of. Since 2003, Ticket Liquidator has been connecting buyers and sellers with the most sought-after and often sold-out events across the country. Ticket Liquidator's nationwide network gives you access to one of the largest online inventories of sports, theater, and concert tickets, with prices lower than most companies in other markets. And our security policies are solid, so you can buy with absolute confidence. More tickets, better service, and lower prices, so you can witness the best entertainment, culture, and sports events worldwide. At Ticket Liquidator, we know that seeing a legend bring down the house or watching your team win the championship is about more than a ticket. It's about being there. For all your sports and entertainment ticket needs, call us at 855-638-3034. Again, that's 855-638-3034.
Who says we don't play? We don't show love to women rappers on the Doug Stewart Show. We definitely do that. The great Salt-N-Pepa. This is the Doug Stewart Show. The number is 404-382-0338. You can email me as well at doug@thedougstewartshow.com. We're going to talk about the Houston Texans here in a second. But I got to tell you first about my good friends from Strickland Security. Strickland Security can install the latest state-of-the-art alarm system in your home. But you know what? Maybe that's not in your budget. The team at Strickland Security can fix your existing system or install just a basic alarm system to your home so that it's protected. No upselling and no contracts. That's a big thing that I haven't talked a lot about with the good folks from Strickland Security. No contracts. That's right. It's possible with Strickland Security. Most security companies only want to sell you a new system, but not at Strickland Security. They want to help you protect your home and your family. If you're in bed, if you're just chilling in the backyard, if you're taking naps on the couch, if your wife is home alone, if your kids are home alone, don't wait until it's too late. Get an alarm system. You've seen it, man, over the last couple of weeks. If you live in Metro Atlanta, that crime has been on the rise in some parts of town, man. So do what you need to do to protect your family in advance. Don't wait. All right? Don't be like, I wish I did this and I wish I did that. No, no. Holla at my folks at StricklandSecurity.com. Once again, StricklandSecurity.com. Or you can give them a call at 800-422-9075. Once again, that's 800-422-9075. And tell them that the Doug Stewart Show sent you. Yes! Yes! All right, the Houston Texans. Coming to this season, second-year head coach Bill O'Brien. You know, he came from college ranks coaching the Penn State Nittany Lions and all of that stuff with Jerry Sandusky, the new coach after Joe Paterno. So he left them, and this will be his second year coaching the Houston Texans. This is a funny dude, man. If you've seen Hard Knocks and you've seen this guy, typical, you know, New Englander type guy, cusses a lot, thinks he's filming a movie or something on Goodfellas or Scarface or something like that, uses the F word every single sentence. Once again, typical New England type badass wannabe guy. He's funny to me. But if you watch Hard Knocks, man, he is going off on these cats, cussing left and right. I mean, he kind of reminds me of my little league football coach, or my junior varsity football coach, Ken Green. I mean, just cusses like a sailor. But well thought of in coaching circles, a guy that's going to bring in a lot of discipline. And you see he definitely makes discipline a precedent with that organization. So this is his second year coaching the Tennessee or the Houston Texans. Here are a couple of new additions to the team from this offseason. They add Brian Hoyer, who we'll talk about more in a second. Raheem Moore, defensive back. Vince Wilfork is obviously one of the bigger signings, even though he's old as hell. You're talking about a guy that's going to anchor that defensive line. Vince Wilfork is that guy. He's a space eater. Was a space eater for many, many years for the New England Patriots and helped them win Super Bowls. Now, at the end of his career, he is going to anchor that defensive line for the Houston Texans. Kevin Johnson, rookie defensive back as well. And the only major subtraction from the team is they lose Andre Johnson, who once again is a guy who's a little bit long in the tooth and has lost a step or two. Now he's catching passes for the Indianapolis Colts and Andrew Luck. But yeah, that defense. It's all about the defense, man. Vince Wilfork in the middle. Then you got Jadeveon Clowney on the outside. And obviously, when you talk about defense, you're talking about, and I'm drawing a blank on his name right now, big defensive end, big white kid that's just an absolute animal for those guys. And I'm drawing a blank right now. You're listening to the Doug Stewart Show. Why am I drawing a blank for this guy? J.J. Watt. J.J. freaking Watt. And that's what happens in live radio sometimes. But obviously, J.J. Watt at the defensive end position on one side. Jadeveon Clowney looks to be healthy this year. Second year in the NFL, missed the entire season last year. Stud defensive end out of the University of South Carolina. Homeboy of Doug Stewart and the Doug Stewart Show. I am so excited to see this guy. They said he's good to go. He had the microfracture surgery this offseason and looks good in drills and training. But they're just not going to put him out there. The last thing I read is he is not going to play any of these preseason games, but they're going to line his ass up game one. Can you imagine a healthy Jadeveon Clowney on one side and J.J. Watt on the other side? I mean, can you imagine that? And then you got the space heater once again and Vince Wilfork in the middle, Brian Cushing, all-pro type linebacker as well in the middle. Their defense could be really, really special this year. When you look at that AFC South division and you talk about the Indianapolis Colts, and who else is in there? The Jacksonville Jaguars and Tennessee. Clearly, they're the second best team in that conference behind Indianapolis. A lot of people got the Colts winning the Super Bowl this year. Andrew Luck with all the new weapons that he has, and you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show. Andrew Luck with all the new weapons that he has. It's a foregone conclusion that they're going to win the AFC South. A lot of people picked them to win the Super Bowl. Here's some questions concerning the Houston Texans coming in to the season this year. One of the major questions was the quarterback position. You had a battle between Ryan Mallett and Brian Hoyer. That competition is over. The Colts, or the Texans, have named Brian Hoyer the starting quarterback for the team. I don't know about that. I'm not there at practice every day with these guys. They are, and clearly, if they chose him to be the starting quarterback, I guess he is, but that's not saying a lot at all. Not a fan of Brian Hoyer. He's a backup quarterback. That's what he feels like to me, is a backup quarterback. So there's a lot to be desired from the quarterback position. Can Jadeveon Clowney stay healthy? That's the thing. Can he stay healthy? Even when he was at college, there was some question about his motor and about his work ethic. And he had little nicks where he had these little hamstring pulls, this, that, and the other. Can this guy stay healthy? That's a huge, huge question mark for the team. And what are they going to do about Arian Foster not being there this year after an injury sidelines him for the season? This blue kid, as well as they've got a couple other running backs that they're looking to see if they can fill that void. So Very interesting year for the Houston Texans. I think this is a team that's probably going to finish somewhere between 9-7, 10-6, maybe even win 11 games. And are probably going to fall short, though, of a Super Bowl because of the staunch competition in the AFC, and in particular in their division right there in the AFC South. So there you have it, the Houston Texans. Yeah. I like their uniform. and I've always, I guess, growing up during the era of the Oilers and Earl Campbell and who else? Dan Pastorini, and then later on Warren Moon. Always loved the Oilers organization, the franchise, the Houston fan base down there. It'd be good to see them start winning some football games and compete. Everything will be, back in order at that point. All right, 404-382-0338 is the number to the show. You can also email me at Doug@thedougstewartshow.com. Getting your thoughts on all that we've talked about today on the show. As far as football, Michael Vick. We talked a little bit about Derrick Rose. Just talked about the Houston Texans. I want to get your thoughts on everything. Let me read more of your chat here before we jump to a break. From Vince Wright, he says, "Ride raw, take my thing out." Okay, is that going to be the hashtag now for the show? Ride raw was it initially. Boiled peanuts was it. It was one time we went real hard with boiled peanuts, which we still have that award tomorrow we have to nominate and vote on. And so now I guess it's taking my thing out. From Quasicutu Hoduchu, "Mama never taught him strip club manners." No, she didn't. You're talking about my homeboy. My homeboy. That's a true story. I have never told or fabricated any story that I've ever told on the Doug Stewart Show, even Two Live Stews. That just keeps it real. And it's funny, if you're from my hometown, you'll never in a million years get me to divulge who this person was because it could be really damaging. The person is well known. The person is well known back at the crib. That's all I'm going to say. He might even be listening right now. And if he is listening right now, know that me and my brother are true, true friends. We have never discussed or divulged your identity to anybody. We've told that story several times before, but we never divulged your identity, sir. From Thorny Switch, "Damn, I can't stop laughing." From Felpay, "Don't want to go to Monk's Corner now. Cats walking around with their things hanging out." That's not the case.
You said it.
That's not
I'm
the case.
Definitely. I was going to try to go up there to see your boy, that singing man.
What singing man?
What's that dude?
Yeah, but he's not. I can't remember his name right now. Not Marvin Cease.
The one who watched his girlfriend from the hotel room.
Yeah, I'll never remember that guy's name right now. What's his name? Old country blues type singer. Traveling the Chitlin Circuit type guy. From Rel Scott, "Take my thing out" has a nice ring to it. All right, see, y'all going too far now. John the Company Man, "Dude went ladies man on him. Excuse me while I whip this out." You're exactly right. Which, by the way, is a very good movie. A very good movie. Have you ever seen that movie, Tree? You never seen Ladies Man?
I don't like that dude. Is that the
the dude
actor
from Saturday Night Live? Yeah.
I don't like him.
Oh my gosh, this movie is hilarious.
I don't like looking at him. He hurts my retina.
When you talk about slept on comedies, Ladies Man is one. Half Baked with Dave Chappelle is just hilarious. I mean, it's just hilarious. Check out those two movies. If you've never seen Half Baked or The Ladies Man, make sure you rent those on a weekend or something. A little popcorn movie with you and the old lady. You'll love it. You will absolutely love those movies. From KC, "When your mama took you to the store, she said, 'Don't touch nothing.' When Doug takes his homeboys to the Schumacher establishment, he tells them, 'Don't take nothing out.'" Yeah. From Vince Wright, "From Monk's going to the Myrtle Manor, trailer park-ish, whatever." Ronald Cameron, he says, "Ryan would have said his name, laugh out loud." No, I think Ryan had actually told that story before back in the day. He didn't say the person's name. I mean, this is something that we can't play around with. We can't do that to this guy. And he might lose his job or whatnot behind something like this. From Vince Wright. Doug, did your friend ride a short yellow bus to school? No. No, he did not ride a yellow bus. He wasn't one of them type of kids. This guy actually went to college. Oh, damn. I narrowed it down a little bit more. Jeez. All right. This guy didn't go to college. We'll be back. The Doug Stewart Show. What is 911 Tax Relief? It's a tax relief company that can help you reduce or remove your IRS or state tax debt. They'll help stop bank levies and wage garnishments by implementing offers in compromise or penalty abatements. 911 Tax Relief is a tax relief company, but they're different from the others. Their experts are licensed enrolled tax agents, and they also have more than 12 years experience helping people solve their tax problems. They're a tax relief company that understands how the IRS works, and they'll also put that knowledge to work for you so they can get you the best possible settlement or solution to your tax problems. Highly rated by the Better Business Bureau, and they've helped thousands of people solve their tax problems. So, don't play around. Click on their link on my website and let 911 Tax Relief help you in your situation with Uncle Sam.
The best of the Doug Stewart Show.
I only want to see you only in the purple rain. Oh, yeah! Woo!
The soulful sounds of Doug Stewart is not for everyone. Side effects may include delusion.
Caller, thanks for calling the Doug Stewart Show. What's your name? Where you calling from? And what do you want to talk about?
Man, this is Chico the Alpha. What's up, man?
Chico the Alpha, how you doing, brother?
All I want to say is that I want to give my appreciation for that rendition.
From Run CNC. He says, what the hell is this? Who got 600 apples so that we can hear Doug sing another song? One song isn't enough. What the hell is this? That's from Run CNC. Thank you, Run CNC. People commenting on my singing a little bit. From Chef Ivan the Great. He says, we don't want to read that one. He's talking about a song called Acid Rain. I saw him Purple Rain, not Acid Rain, so I don't know what you're talking about, sir. From Gary Joyner. He says, I felt the pain in that song, Doug. Yes, you did. You felt the pain and the sorrow and the burden. Just like Prince. I could have been a stand-in for Prince and Purple Rain in the movie.
Other side effects include nausea, dry mouth, complete hearing impairment for a 24-hour period.
The Purple Rain. Honey, I know times are changing. Woo!
And scientific studies have shown these sounds to be an effective contraceptive. The Doug Stewart Show. Sports talk. Straight. No chaser.
This is your folk, Doug Stewart. Want to protect you and your family from life's unexpected mishaps? Then join 7. Join 7 is a prepaid legal company under the umbrella of the Protection Group. Join 7 is the only group benefit or motor club in the U.S. that offers auto reimbursement coverage, key replacement coverage, roadside assistance, gives you a current Medi-File, prescription savings, and fully encompassed prepaid legal benefits that include identity theft. They got you back. The average combined cost to purchase these benefits individually is over $850 a year. Join today and take advantage of all 7 for $17 a month. They've been around for over 20 years, so check them out by clicking on the banner link on my page, thedougstewartshow.com, or the app. Just go ahead and join 7.
Once again, we tango for cash. Razz Cash, Dr. Dre, and Mac 10 connected. We get them fabulous, baby. The best food, drink, and pussy that money can buy. Every day of my life is off the ringer. That's guaranteed. Like a fist fight on Jerry Springer. I got the hottest flow to hit the street since Lava. So holla, we all hustle for dollars. From Sac to Houston, New Orleans to D.C. We drinking VSOP, the beats beat. Banking, catch me with a dime piece next to me. My body all over your body like LSG. Neighborhood celeb with the keys to my city like the mayor. Rookies asking us how to be the player. Get in where you fit in.
miss her. You know, I ain't seen her in a long time, but so there you go, Jersey said happy anniversary. Man, I was thinking about when you talk about the strip clubs, remember the Hennessy tour, man? Those were the days, man.
Okay, welcome back to the Doug Stewart Show. From what we understand, we didn't have the microphone together just now. But we're back now. Okay, we're back. We're back. We're back. We're back. We're back. All right, sorry about that. Apologies. We're good now. Welcome back to the Doug Stewart Show. We actually had a call on the line. You may have even been able to hear him. Caller, you still there?
Yes, I'm still here.
Okay, okay.
What's
going on? We got Vern from Jersey on the line. Vern, how you doing, brother? Sorry about that.
Oh, okay, man. I thought you ain't want to talk to a brother, man. But I was talking about the Hennessy tour that you and Ryan used to do back in the days with the stools, man. We used to go to the different strip clubs, man.
Yeah.
Man, that was the bomb right there, man. I used to love that. But you know what I hate about strip clubs, man? That's why I don't even go no more. Man, you got all these, you know, dykes, man, up there. You know, once they come set camping at that table and whatnot, all the girls run over there to them. Why is that, D? I don't understand that, man.
Yeah, I don't know exactly what he's talking about. But yeah, the strip club scene here in Atlanta, if you go on a certain night and you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show, if you go on certain nights and he used a derogatory term towards homosexual women, which I frown upon, and you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show. If you go on certain nights here in this town, there are more women. There's like 5-1 women in the audience, I guess is the best way to put it. In some of these shoe modeling establishments, 5-1 women. And so that's kind of like the thing now by that group of ladies. And it's just very interesting. It's very interesting. Now, it's not like that all the time. But, yeah, you go on like a Tuesday night or something like that on the Humbug, which I don't do that type of thing. I haven't done that type of thing in a long, long time. Just on the Humbug on a Tuesday or Wednesday night, go to a shoe modeling establishment. But, yeah, there's a real, real heavy contingency of women that love strip clubs here in the ATL. So I don't think that you heard actually me talk about it because we had an issue with the microphone. But I talked a little bit about Kobe Bryant and Shaquille O'Neal. Shaq has his podcast, and Kobe Bryant actually called up. And you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show. He actually called the podcast and, in a way, kind of buried the hatchet, kissed and made up from all the beef that they had back in the day when they played for the Los Angeles Lakers. And Kobe talked about how he said some things when he were younger that he shouldn't have said, and in challenging Shaq, being an older guy. And Shaq said that he wished that he would have handled things differently, and that he wished that he had never left L.A. And they kind of kissed and made up. And I thought that was a great thing, man. I mean, seriously, man, life is too short. Why y'all beefing? Yeah, kiss and make up. And as a Laker fan, it really hurts me to think about what could have been and how many rings they could have won there in L.A. They won 3. They could have easily won another couple more rings, man. Easily. So that was good to hear. And then on the bad side, man, a Santa Clara County grand jury indicted former San Francisco 49er defensive lineman Ray McDonald on 1 count of rape of an intoxicated person. The announcement came Wednesday with the indictment stemming from an incident December 15th at McDonald's home. Current 49ers linebacker Ahmad Brooks also has been charged by the Santa Clara District Attorney's Office with misdemeanor sexual battery for an alleged assault the same day involving the same victim. And we talked a little bit earlier about Derrick Rose and that whole situation, man, that's coming out right now. I just hate to hear these type of things, man. Once again, it's almost like, it feels like, and maybe I'm wrong, and I'm not a young person. I'm not in my mid-20s, late 20s, obviously, with all the culture of the young people today. But it seems like there's some type of game-type scenario culture with these date rape drugs, this Molly that they talk about and they glamorize in songs, man. And more of the same with this story about Ray McDonald and Ahmad Brooks as well. We'll keep our eye on the story. This is the Doug Stewart Show. Thank you so much for joining me. Let me grab another call. Caller, thanks for calling the Doug Stewart Show. What's your name? Where are you calling from? What you want to talk about?
Doug Stu, what it do? John Fisher in the building, baby.
John Fisher in the building. What up, baby?
What's going on, Doug? First of all, man, you can't be talking about two grown men kissing, dude.
Wait a minute. What two grown men were kissing? I missed that.
You said that Shaq and Kobe kissing made up, man.
Okay, got you. Yeah, they're doing a little.
What are you doing all of these previews, dog? When are you going to talk about my Eagles, man? They're coming down here week one to put the beat down on the Falcons, asses. What are you going to talk about my Eagles, dog?
Well, what we plan to do, what we've been doing, John Fisher, is we go from worst to first. And so that's a good sign, actually. We haven't talked about your Eagles yet.
Got you. Hey, man. I'm looking forward for the weekend of the 26th, man, because it's going down for real. I look forward to meeting you and all the Stewies out there, man. We're going to do a big that weekend, dog.
That's what's up, man. I can't wait for you to come down, man. We're going to do it real, real big, man.
Yes, sir. All right. Hey, y'all make sure everybody out there, you get that Uber app, because we don't see nobody going to the pokey.
Yeah, exactly. Thanks for the call, John Fisher. He's exactly right, man. Be careful. I mean, we're going to get loose. Like Puffy and Pharrell, we finna get loose on the weekend of September 26th. But you got to be careful, man. That Uber thing is really taking a bite out of the business of these cab companies. But, yeah, the weekend of September 26th, it is going down. TDSS weekend. TDSSweekend.eventbrite.com. It's going to be crazy. Crazy. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes! Yes! Hey, thank you so much for joining me on the Doug Stewart Show. John Fisher just mentioned it again, man. With a little tease. Huge announcement, man. A huge-ass announcement is coming up. Yes, sir! Praise his holy name.
Camping is not a hymn when you make the announcement.
I'm sorry. Say that again, Tree.
We gonna do some singing when you make the announcement.
Oh, my gosh. Yeah, we going to sing. I might pull out Celebration. Who's that, Cool in the Gang? Celebration? Yeah. It's a celebration.
I might authorize it.
Yeah. So the weekend of September 26th is going down, TDSS weekend, and I got a huge announcement in the next day or so. Stay tuned. Stay tuned. A big-ass announcement. Yeah. Oh, quick. This is going to be great. All right. Thank you so much for joining me today on the Doug Stewart Show. Shouts out to the Tree of Life, the producer to the show. Thank you, Tree, for all that you do. Waterhead, Walter, Dwayne Vassan, Gerald Oliveri, my engineers, thank y'all. And a big special thank you to all of the Stewies, man. Without no you, there would be no me. Yes, thank you. Tell somebody about the Doug Stewart Show. If you want to promote your brand, your company, your product, an event on the Doug Stewart Show, over 9,000 followers, over 200,000 plus listens. Check me out on Fiverr.com. That's Fiverr.com. All right, we'll do it again tomorrow. Same Doug Stewart time, same Doug Stewart channel. Peace.